Okay, we are back. Sorry about that. We had a little bit of trouble, but I did notice we got a pack, so we're gonna check out what we got. Yeah. Let's look in the store, see what it's got. It's like card stuff. Yes, I'm a little bit preoccupied trying to get things restarted here. Card styles in the deal of the day. Card styles I already have, but you might like them. 90% off. You can't beat that. All right, here we go. We're going to try this one more time. Can we find somebody who wants to play this game? We have ideas for some new stuff coming your way and possibly some new games as well, so hang in there. We appreciate your support. Even if Wizards doesn't want to shuffle my game here. So, hopefully our audio is better. Yesterday we took some time working on audio issues. We're not going to do that. That is an illegitimate game right there. That's three in a row. If you guys can't bring games and decks that play cards, I mean real magic, not this shit that you're playing, we won't be back. We won't be bringing it to the stream anymore. Said it before, and it's the last time. Wizards has got to fix their game. They gotta stop shuffling based on your win-loss record. It's cheating. It's rigging the game. And they gotta fix it. Anybody who even comes close to believing that that's not what they're doing hasn't really played the game long enough to know. It is definitely what you're doing. Again, no mana, and these decks, they got 30 mana or so in them, and they're not cheap on mana for their 60 or 70 cards in the deck. It didn't matter, huh? Hey, if you're out there, why not give us a follow? Share our content in your groups, on your timeline. It really, really helps to also invite your friends, start conversations. We will get there eventually. Sometimes we miss when somebody pops in the chat, though. We do have Facebook open right here on the laptop right next to us, and Twitch is running in the background behind the game. Sometimes we miss your coming in. Well, we do eventually see you there. Burn them up. Burn them if you got them. Burn them like you got to. So much is wrong with this computer. People should leave it alone. Void Wipes. Too powerful, guys.
Will make quick work of you.
Well, we're not dealing with this. I don't care. Win, lose, or draw. You're stretching the game out too long. 3 to 5 minutes. That's the end. 3 to 5 minutes, guys. If you can't do it in that time, you can't do it. There's no game. This is not home at your kitchen table. This is digital. That's what there is. You keep the excitement going or you get out of it. Now bring decks that are playable in the casual play mode where we're sitting in this platform here. Casual, historic. If you want to play commander decks, if you want to play ladder decks, play them where they belong, not here. That's why the game has gone downhill. And nobody wants to watch it. Nobody's streaming it anymore because nobody's watching it. Keep it moving. Stop the bullshit. Thank you. No, I don't go for it. I don't care. Win, lose, or draw. It's not worth sitting around doing that shit. Okay? Play the game or don't come at all. Don't bother coming starting the game. Why turn your computer on to do that? Why waste $100 to do that? I don't get it. don't care no more. I'm not wasting my time with you. You either want to play cards or you don't. If you don't bother coming. We don't need people who don't want to play cards in a card game. What we don't need is people who don't want to play cards. That's a pretty good sign that you don't want to play cards right there, okay? Put some cards on the board for real. You don't need a handicap before the game starts. You just don't, okay? A planeswalker is a handicap. If you're that handicapped, get a new deck. Learn something about the game instead of importing cards from online and stealing other people's strategies that you don't understand. Build your own decks. Handicaps are for end game, in case you need help. They're not for the start of the game. I don't play against decks like this either, because you're not playing cards. Come on. Like I said, bring a deck where you play cards. This is not playing cards. You put your cards on that board there and play them out. You don't do this crap. That is not somebody who wants to play cards. Guys, the cards go on the board. Even a kid playing Go Fish knows you put the card on the board. The guy with the bigger card wins. That's magic, except it's got angels, dragons, and flying. Other than that, the rest of it's bullshit. Put the cards on the board. Play your cards. If you can't do that, build a new deck. And yes, build the deck. Don't steal the deck. Don't import the deck from somebody else. Don't take something you don't understand. Build a deck. Again, you're not playing cards here. That's not a card game. That is stupid. You're not playing cards. You're not giving the game a chance. Play cards. One more time and we're out of here too, because I ain't got time for crap. You're either playing cards or you aren't. That's the bottom line here. We're here to play cards, play cards. Don't take the coward's way out of anything. Again, coward's way out, my friend. Play the game or don't bother coming to the game at all. What's the point if you're not going to play? If you're not going to bring a deck that you made yourself? If you're going to steal strategy that you don't understand? If you're not interested in learning how the game works? Why bother? we're not playing bullshit games again. Once again, bring a deck that makes sense, okay? We are not making sense with this deck, no. Ramp up decks, whether they're black, white, blue, green, they are need to be controlled. There is no point in having two plays and having the other side up to 25 life from 20. Makes no sense. If you want a little ramp up at the end to help you out, that's one thing. To ramp up like that at the beginning of the game, or to have a handicap like that, or any handicap whatsoever at the beginning of a game, just means you don't know how to play the game, and you should learn how. You should learn how to build your own strategy. Again, taking decks from online. Now I'm starting to play Mirror Mirror games where they're taking my decks from me, from the trackers, which shouldn't be allowed to happen either. That's the same thing as importing strategy that you don't understand. Build your own decks, guys. Build them yourself. Yes, it takes time. You gotta wait. They never should have put wild cards, first of all, for sale in the store. Because it just takes away from the building of your own deck. I mean, it does take time to build up a good game, as it should. This is another ramp up deck that's just looking in my hand, and no, I am not playing this shit. I'm just not. You're not getting the game from me. Until you bring a deck that makes sense, until they match me with a deck that makes sense, until they shuffle my cards in a way that makes sense, you're not getting a game. If they want to tie it to the win-loss record, we can make sure we lose enough to win again, so they'll shuffle my cards. That's all there is to it. That's how they want you to play the game. Quit until you got below 50%. Then you win until you got above 50%. Then you lose again. That's how they want you to play. That is how their shuffle is rigged. Anybody really wants to know, if you win six games and you lose five, you win six more. Essentially. The ratio is a little different than that, but it's basically what it amounts to. Win five, lose six. Lose six, win five. It's just enough to keep the economy they used to have going, but it don't work no more since they've raised all the prices and put wild cards in the store, just like they said it wouldn't. This, my friend, is a white ramp-up deck stolen from online. If you can't play your own cards, then you can't play at all. And I'll just keep quitting until they shuffle my cards. I beat either way. Like I said, I don't have to play the game. I just keep quitting until you shuffle my cards and match me the way I should be. Because as soon as I lose enough, that's exactly what's going to happen. Isn't it wonderful to play a game that's so predictable? I'm sure if Apex Legends or Fortnite or any of them were this predictable, they wouldn't have any life expectancy whatsoever. Would you just fucking get out there already? Jesus Christ. Okay. Nope, that don't make no sense either. They don't even have the manner to justify having such a card out in the game. So, bye-bye. Goodbye-bye. Build a deck that makes sense. In fact, you don't even have to build a deck that makes sense. They just have to make a match that makes sense. That match makes no sense. You got 4 mana and a card with 7 power. That don't work. The math on that alone don't work. Forget the rest of it. This is what happens when you fuck the logic of a game up entirely, beyond repair. I don't get it. What the fuck is so hard about playing that card? Nope. Ramp up decks are not acceptable. Bye. Tired of it. Ramp up decks are not acceptable. Come back when you grow up. Even though most Magic players now are 103 years old. So bear with me, guys. In about 2 seconds, I'm ready to win the rest of the games, the one right after the other, because I've lost enough to win now. Forced losses, but losses nonetheless. White ramp-ups? No, I'm not here to accept that. Sorry, we don't accept white ramp-up decks. Nope, not for 1 minute. There you go. Here come the winds, my friend, just like I said. Some will be forced and some will be hard fought, but there will be all winds tonight.
Take him out!
Your board wipes are too powerful.
Thank you.
don't have time for this. Either want to play or they don't. They're not thinking. You can tell they're not thinking. They're not even looking at their cards. If they were thinking, they'd be checking them out. They're showing signs of no brain activity whatsoever. No, we're not playing against this. Put cards on the board, or don't bother playing. That's the name of the game here. Bye-bye. And though I gave him the defeat, which I really didn't, I just decided it wasn't matched correctly, I got the win, which probably will guarantee me smooth sailing to the end of my game. Provided they can find a match at all. You don't need a handicap with all the help you got there without a handicap.
For a hero?
You know, with all the mana you got, you really don't need that handicap. You really don't. I really don't. I don't get what they're doing here.
And some think time only flows in one direction.
No, you know what? No, you don't need the handicap. You're not going to have the handicap. We'll see you later. Loser. Guys, Planeswalkers, one per deck, at the end of the game, it's an end game. At the beginning of the game, it's a cheat. And you know what? Cheating doesn't go with me or anybody else for that matter. And that guy had so much mana, he didn't need any help. All he had to do was cast the right card. If he had to have a Planeswalker, he needs a new deck with all the mana he had. Now they can't make a match, so there's that, right? They don't even have anybody who can play. We have to find a good match. All the players are gone. This is a ramp-up deck. We are not going to play this if it continues. Nope, why not? You can either send a real play, send a real deck, or go home. Man, now you can see why I am looking for a new game. Not only do we not get any comments or any discussions or anything about this game, so far as I can tell, we haven't had a viewer. Yet, all I did was switch and play Eternal yesterday, and we had 100 people or more. That is the problem right now. Wizards of the Coast is dead. The Magic the Gathering is dead. And that's why they're pushing Dungeons & Dragons so hard. And they're not only pushing it hard, but they moved the game, the people who take care of the game, is not even Wizards anymore. They hired somebody else to do it. And this one's all mana, so I don't even know if we're going to be able to play this one out. Hi guys, we're gonna call it a game for here. And see you later. Bye.